So there's Lovell's, this is the record shop that pretty much grew up and just saw all the DVDs, all the records that inspired my craft today. Before film, I did a lot of music, or I got into music because of film. So like, you know, using soundtracks, getting into, I've always grown up with like a alternative, like, you know, indie phase. And then I feel like that translated, like I used those songs in my films, my short films, just because it set the tone. And that's how I kind of edited and cut clips together, by connecting it with the song. So a song, even sometimes just the training before, I would literally use songs, download movies from like YouTube and movie scenes, and pick a song that I feel like connects to that movie. And that's good training, you know, as a filmmaker, just because like you're just moving with the rhythm of the music and using both art forms, you know. And I would use like fucking Panic at the Disco, or no, Panic by The Smiths. Could life ever be sane again? The neat side streets that you slip down. And put it with like a movie scene from like Boogie Nights. You know, that type of shit. Just like, they didn't use that type of music because they use like more 80s, 70s music. Why not put some like 90s shit on it? Or even recently, I'll put like, because I'm also into like trap and SoundCloud. So I'll use like Fonny, American Muscle. It's a heavy like 808 record. I use that over the movie Drive with Ryan Gosling. Like, things that are just totally different, but you know, like, you wouldn't hear that shit usually in that kind of movie, but it still connects with that scene. Pretty much, my parents were from the Philippines, and like, they didn't really have American music taste. So then my sister got all her music taste from just this city and being around people in Whittier. And we were kind of like growing up, obviously, like that was like early 2000s. We were the only Asians around like our class. So then we had to fit into like, okay, like what some people were into. But obviously, like, we're outcasted. So then we would listen to all like the rock shit with like the punk kids, the skater kids, you know? And there's a couple albums I'll probably just pick out right now. It's all this, pretty much, you know. The Smiths. Too long, she said. And of course, like all like the pop punk stuff, like Blink-182 and all that. Yeah, definitely some Radiohead. This one, obviously, like the iconic one. This is my sister's favorite. And, you know, she put me on to a lot of songs from her, like Lift. Let Down. Oh yeah. So the Pixies, literally Fight Club put me on to them. I think it was this album. Oh yeah, that's like the Where's My Mind, of course. Popular ass song. But I feel like recently, what I do respect about social media and TikTok and all that is that showing newer kids who didn't know these movies maybe or music. So like, I've seen like Fight Club and like American Psycho come back in my For You page. I'm like, oh damn, like it's putting people on like those movies and the music that was in those movies. So it's pretty dope. Like, now my 12-year-old cousin knows about American Psycho when obviously movies now aren't the same. So like it's cool that they're getting put on to look back at those movies and even the music too.
It's weird, like, you know, obviously there's a lot of times it was like
they're right over here. They're more newer. Isle is Fire. No, you don't. Not a fucking gen. With your rhyme and your reason. Definitely a vibe. Of course. essentials. Does matter. I remember like going to a concert in 2016. Mosh pits were crazy. And then I remember like just all of the newer wave punk bands that like brought back that sound, the post-punk sound. Joyce Manor was one of them. It was pretty dope. I also really fuck with like The Garden. Just in that whole like freshman year in high school, like I remember me and the homie Diego and Aubrey and Michael and all them, Grego. We would just go to like all those like, you know, Mac and Marco, Beach House, Kuko, just all those new wave indie, kind of bringing back that post-punk sound, indie alternative sound. Whenever I'm feeling like kind of, you know, like creator's block or whatever, I go to this store at Lovell's in Whittier. And I just look at, if I don't know the artist, but the cover looks dope, and this looks like trippy as fuck, you know? Then I get inspiration from just looking at the cover, and then I'll put it on, listen to a whole vinyl at home, see if it's like, if anything clicks in my head, you know? And sometimes I'll still get like records that actually like I know, or I listen to through like Spotify or whatever. And it's cool to even get it practically, like physically hold it, just like a movie. Just like you feel more of a connection with the art itself. Yeah. Another thing too, like I watch movies for movies, you know, like I'll have my serious side of movies, but I also have like if a movie's good when it knows what it's doing. So like the SpongeBob movie. The SpongeBob movie is just as good as fucking Goodfellas, just because it knows what it's doing.
I'm funny how? I mean funny like I'm a clown, I amuse you. I make you laugh, I'm here to fucking amuse you. What do you mean funny? Funny how? How am I funny?
It's in its lane, so that's why it's, you know, it's a good movie, because it's funny, and it's a SpongeBob movie. It's a good gangster movie, and because it executes its topic. So when a movie executes its topic and characters, that makes it a good movie. See, on the surface, it looks like it's an action movie, right? But it's actually like art house, avant-garde type of film.
From now on, every word out of your mouth is the truth. Or I'm gonna hurt you. Do you understand?
Yeah. Nicholas Winding Refn. I remember like, I dove deep into his discography. Honestly, Drive is still his best movie. I feel like Neon Demon and all of them are just like copies of Drive. Respect to him, but yeah, I feel like that's his formula. You know, like this is it.
Thank you so much.
And it's just Ryan Gosling being Ryan Gosling, you know? This is really good. It's my favorite superhero movie. Logan. Yeah, I actually like X-Men more than the Avengers. The only superhero movies I like is, you know, superheroes is Wolverine and Iron Man and Spider-Man. But I feel like Logan is probably one of the better superhero movies of the 2015s, the 2010s and up, you know. Like, I feel like Logan is the first to do like a rated R kind of serious, more dark adult approach. Alright, so you got Breaking Bad seasons 1 through 3. So like, I remember being in 7th grade and I did football, you know, I wasn't the best, but like our coach talked about Breaking Bad and I just loved it, you know. I feel like, because he grew up in East LA, my coach, and he said that, oh, like seeing cartels being represented in a show like this, obviously this is Albuquerque, but you know, he loved it for that, he thought it was really authentic. And I was already into like crime movies, thrillers, and then when I first watched the show in 7th grade, my parents didn't really care what I watched, because honestly, they didn't even understand it. Like, they watched Filipino shows and Filipino media, you know? Immigrant parents, first gen. So when I watched Breaking Bad, it was just in the background. I mean, obviously it's violent. In the first episode, you see literal bodies getting fucking burnt down. But
yeah, like I feel like Breaking Bad, you know, Vince Gilligan set the tone for the type of movies I want to make. And it's just that, like, you know,
also like it's so close to you guys that I get it. Like,
you know, just doing, like, seeing the landscape shots, super wide shots when he plays in these shows. I feel like there's such a feeling to them that, like, you let the environment, you're in the scene, you know, like you let that all marinate in your head, and it's like you're in there with the characters.
And by now, if you could buy stock,
I feel like his cinematography, his editing, his direction in this show.
I have like an able name
that. Yeah, it's sure. It's slow. You know, it's like slow burn. But that slow burn feel makes you feel like you're there with the characters. You know, you really, you see Walter White and Jesse's journey. Walter White's character development into becoming somebody that he was always going to be. You know, he sees himself as a villain. Because honestly, like, Walter White's the villain of the show, for being honest. Yeah, he had good intentions, but he becomes that villain. It's like an anti-hero. So this is like one of my, probably like my number one favorite show. For sure.
Doing movies at a young age, obviously I love branching out. Movies are my number one, no matter what. But sometimes you feel some creative burnout. Sometimes you want to branch out so you inspire that art form. So I had to take a break for a little bit from movies. Or let's say I'm like burnt out from movies or like making videos, music videos, then music's always there and I would make music. So, obviously, like, rap is probably the easiest thing to start with. So, like, yeah, I started rapping when I was trash. So then I just, like, stuck to singing and doing, like, alternative, indie, pop, rock, trap, fuse type stuff. I'm fucking with your energy. I feel you like the face. I'ma tell you my intentions, baby. This ain't no game. Karaoke on a Wednesday night. And I feel like Gunna, when he made Wanna, his album Wanna, that was like the perfect fusion of like electronic house melodies with 808 trap, Atlanta trap, bass, you know. I feel like that's like my favorite album. I was in the trenches rocking Gucci and Dior. BET was tripping high, thinking in the war. You got me annoyed. Double pop the US. Of course, Kanye, you know. I feel like he's one of those artists, you know, timeless. Ever since the beginning, like, who doesn't respect his music, you know? And I feel like he changed hip-hop, like, he influenced all the new rappers. How could you be so heartless? How could you be so cold as the winter wind when it breeze, yo? Just remember that you talking to me, though. You need to watch the way you talking to me, yo. I mean, after all, he made hip-hop seem like, okay, you don't have to be a gangster to rap, right? He implemented so many different sounds, from electronic, rock, fucking, you know, 80s sounding stuff. He did it first with all his production, and he implemented it, and he put that to hip hop, you know. So that's like the go. I feel like Drake or Kanye, because revolutionized the sound for like forever. Drake only makes like, oh, Drake has like hits, you know. He has like classic bangers, you know, like Up All Night. Whatever, man. Fuck what they be talking about. Their opinion doesn't count. We the only thing that matters. Oh, so we do it how we do it. All up his mixtape and all that, when he first started rapping, I feel like that's the best Drake. You know, he actually rapped about real shit. But then, now he just makes music for like frat boys. Which is my favorite. This is the best album ever. Never go out with Lizzo. If you didn't know, David Lynch made the original Dune. Now they have a remake with Zendaya and Tim Chalamet. But yeah, honestly, his movie of Dune, his version, wasn't the best. It's kind of crazy because David Lynch was like, he was him back then. Like, he made Eraserhead, all the experimental shit, Twin Peaks. It's kind of cool seeing that they got the soundtrack on vinyl, you know? It's always you.
Ooh.
No way. John Wick.
That's fire.
How did Rhino Records get the Acoustic Gorillaz postcards?
John Williams, you know, all the classics.
We don't get shit.
You know, all the classic Spielberg soundtracks. And there's one thing for sure is that, you know, my top genres are rock and hip hop. But soul, I didn't really dive deep into soul R&B actually. Now, I do love Motown, it gets you in the mood. But, so yeah, I try to get grasp every genre, just have an open ear.
If I could reverse the time, these moments just flew. We were sipping audios, and your lips were kinda blue. And your homegirls just left, cause they saw me in the room. Way she busted wide open, and my butterfly group, and my butterfly group. She turned her location off, cause she fucking with a fool. And my butterfly group, and my butterfly group. Fuck you with the lights on, wanna see your face.